all of the shows. Flat rich kid got all of the clothes. People like you get all of the nose. I stay making wins, I stay with the pros. Just made a stack, I'm watching it grow. Up in the sky, everybody so low. I keep me like foe, he sleep on the floor. He don't got no money, I show him the dough. Oh no, kid can't never with a bozo. Name in his mouth like Froyo. With a rich baddie, looking for the bros. If he really with it, make him cash out the code, oh, bro. Any, many, miny, mo. All this money, I need mo. Don't want your bro, it was for show. Just so you know, we just wanna get lit. We just wanna get lit. We just wanna get lit. We just wanna get lit, 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 lit. Any, many, miny, mo. All this money, I need mo. Don't want your bro, it was for show. Just so you know, we just wanna get lit. We just wanna get lit. We just wanna get lit. We just wanna get lit, 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 lit. Any, many, miny, mo. All this money, I need mo. Give him a show, killing you nose and taking your bro. Your man and spinning his bands. Oh yeah, did it again. Oh yeah, out with his friend. Oh yeah, Chanel is the lens. Okay. With his friend finna get lit. I'm everything on they wish list. Which bag should I get? Get. Which color should I pick? Pick. Any, mini, miny, mo. All his money, I need mo. You big bro, gotta go. Big bird giving crow. A group of baddies coming foe. Give me money, kiss my toes. Go with your bro, it was for show. Just so you know, we just wanna get lit. We just wanna get lit. For show, just so you know, we just wanna get lit. 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 Lit, lit, lit. Any, many, miny, mo. All this money, I need mo. Give him a show, killing you nose and taking your bro.
It's the NFL on EA Sports as we are in the inner harbor of Baltimore at M&T Bank Stadium. There's a scene a short time ago. The Ravens introduced to this sellout crowd, and through a sea of pyrotechnics, out they came from the tunnel. We're set to go as the Ravens get ready to match up with the Denver Broncos. Justin Tucker set to boom this one away. T Bank Stadium. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. Touchdown. Here's McManus now to kick it away. They'll elect to bring it out here from the end zone. Yeah. Dolphins come up now first and 10 at their own 25-yard line. Throw right side is complete to Andrews, his tight end. And he's going to be dropped following a pickup of 7, past the 30 to the 32. First carry for the former Buckeye, J.K. Dobbins. And he's going to have a Ravens first down as the tackle made at about the 38.
First there, and he nicely bit off a pretty decent game.
Of a full 3 yards on first down. So maybe just a momentary setback on what's been a great drive so far, but second and 13 here. Option play, and they'll hand the defense. Just a yard there, so it brings up a tough third and 12. Being chased out left. And he nearly got the first himself, but it appears he's going to be about a yard or two short. After one, 7-0 on EA Sports. The offense staying out. They're going to go on fourth and 2. Now it's Jackson. Two-point conversion. Well, look to throw. And it's caught. He's got it. So they go for 2. They convert, and along with it, they'll take an 8-7 lead. kick it away following the touchdown. And here comes a return from the middle of the end zone. Field ready to start their next drive. And they had to wait a long time to get the football back. Probably not what you were hoping for when you got an offensive time.
Agreed. What you were looking for is the defense get the ball back pretty quickly, right? Hoping for a three and out. So that didn't happen. You can't yell at your team for that. They've got to take care of their own business and reestablish themselves now that they're back on the field.
On second and nine. Bridgewater. It's his running back. And loses the football. It's loose. And it's picked up by the Ravens. But they have possession. And they have it at the 38-yard line. Always costly to cough up that football. These defenders, they become so adept, though, at jarring it free.
Yeah, it's amazing that there aren't more fumbles caused, because now, if you're an offensive player, you go through ball security drills every single day. It's really not out of line to think that you take the ball to bed with you and just hold on to it. But the bottom line is, no matter how much you try to protect it, these guys are pretty good at finding ways to knock it out.
14 yards that time, and a first down on the keeper. To throw is Jackson. Able to slip it inside the 5-yard line. Escaping the pressure. And he'll take it into the end zone for the Ravens touchdown. Jackson taking it in from 30 yards out as the Ravens push further out in front. This defense, so many things to worry about in the red zone area, but you have to almost think that Lamar Jackson running the football, that might be number one.
It should be number one, and in this portion of the field where things shrink a little bit because the receivers can't run past anyone because they'll run out of real estate, you should have all eyes on Lamar Jackson when the ball is snapped and try and keep him back in the pocket.
Yeah, I don't think that they were surprised he was running it there. They just couldn't stop it, and he ends up in the end zone. So two successful two-point tries now for them.
And you know what it does? It gives you a boost, a huge one for your team, because, hey, you're dominating them now. They can't stop either scoring touchdowns or two-point conversions. But how about the defense? You don't know what to do at this stage. You can't stop them in any direction.
This will be brought out from the middle of the end zone. The Broncos onto the field, ready to start their next drive. And they had the fumble last time that led to a touchdown. That's a no-no. We'll see what they do here this go around.
A big no-no. Put that in capital letters. Turning it over, the other team takes it down and scores. That can be a deflator for a football team. Now it's up to the offense to get back out on the field and pick things up.
You know, they're out there. We'll see if they can pick those things back up. They'll wind up getting nine after tucking it and running, so it'll leave them with second and a yard. Now the throw to his running back. Takes this one down almost all the way to the 30. It's a gain of 34. Bridgewater on first down. He lets this one fly toward the back of the end zone. And this is taken in by Hamler. Touchdown. KJ Hamler. Two catches, two touchdowns here so far. And the Broncos have cut it to within a score. McManus's punt after is good. And the lead is down to two. After the touchdown, here's McManus now to kick it away. And this pass will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. Now the Broncos are going to call the first of their timeouts. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this second quarter. Jackson and the Ravens come up now, first and 10 at their 25-yard line. Ship you off to Orlando. Jonathan Coachman will have first half highlights and analysis from the back and forth first half that we've seen. A gain of 5, good enough for the first down.
Space because they have the ability to make people miss, and they also have the ability to run over people. And if you do that throughout the game, after a while, they might just run through some of those tackles and go a long way.
Well, you saw him shed a nice tackle on that play.
Hey, middle, middle, middle. Back, back, back. Jack.
From the 41, Jackson sliding out of the pocket.
I know he was trying to get the completion downfield, but the way this game has gone, with a few of the runs he's made along the way, he should have kept the ball and taken it with his feet downfield. That's the big play that shreds the defense. Instead, he thought to himself, I'm a quarterback, I've got to throw it.
And now, Kirk Mason's down the right side. And he will have the Ravens first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
Oftentimes now, offenses aren't nearly as precise as days gone by. They just saw receivers find an open patch of grass and let the quarterback find you. And that's exactly what they did on that play. First with the pass through the air. Nice chunk of yardage there. And then additional pickup with his legs after the catch.
And they'll let the quarterback keep it here on first and 10. And this carry, despite the good move, will be stopped short of the 10. Now the Ravens going to use one of their timeouts as they'll stop it with just over 30 seconds to go in the first half. Still 9 remaining on second down. The clock will stop with 35 seconds to go in quarter number 2.
Man.
This offense converted once on fourth down earlier. Now they're out there again to try once more.
31's the mic. Hey, pick it up, defense. Let's go.
We change it. 13, 13.
Jackson now. Hopkins, touchdown, Baltimore. A 7-yard touchdown grab, and the Ravens will add on to their lead. So simple math here in the first half. They've had three drives offensively, and they have scored every time, and they've gotten the lead.
Well, whenever we talk about adjustments, we usually talk about an offense making adjustments, right? This is all about the defense. They've got to figure out some way, somehow, to slow them down. Do they blitz a little bit more? Do they play more zone coverage? Right now, they don't know where to go because they're hitting them in every direction.
They'll try and throw for it. They'll buy some time right. And the Ravens are going to have first and goal as they try to finish off this drive with 6 points. So they kept it on the ground, got it into the end zone. Charles, sometimes you probably see teams treat a two-point conversion differently than if it was first and goal from the two, or I should say third and goal from the two.
I agree with you totally on that. A lot of teams treat it as if they have farther to go and shy away from running the football. I think this is a great spot to do it because most teams play it for the pass. Go ahead and run it, let your linemen surge and fire out.
The Broncos onto the field, ready to start their next drive. And with them down two scores, you wonder if they might try and put something together, even if it's just to get into field goal range. On first and 10, Bridgewater. He'll go up top here for Hamler. And that's into a double team. It's intercepted. Picked off here on 26. And they will take over at the 26-yard line. He's certainly not been afraid to take some chances downfield. Now, look, it's paid off for him a couple of times. That time, not so fortunate.
And that's where I want to start, what you said. It's paid off a couple of times. So his aggressiveness has been good for his offense for the most part. So he throws an interception there. No one likes that. But I would not rein him back in. The return on investment thus far has been pretty good. Two touchdowns to one interception.
Ravens going to use their third and final timeout. As the clock will stop with 18 seconds to go in the first half.
First and 10 at the 39-yard line.
And he'll be taken down at the 46-yard line. Nice work to get 7 out of that, and it's second down. Well, we've seen Jackson already have success in the first half running the football, and he gets good yardage on the ground again there. I mean, how? I know it's a $64,000 question, CD, but how do they contain him better?
You have to win against the blockers ahead of you. If those guys even occupy a defender for even half a second, Lamar Jackson is gone. You got to take those blockers and move them so that you have clear vision of Lamar Jackson, and hopefully you can hand him in.
Second half. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. The Baltimore offense at the line set to get going. And they've got the lead, CD. What do you expect from them in the second half?
Well, I liked what they were able to do on the ground in the first half because they had a lot of success running the ball, and I certainly think we'll see more of that. But I'd keep an eye on that defense, and I think their coaches up in the box will do the exact same thing. If they start to see one or two guys start to creep towards the line of scrimmage, that'll be license to take some shots downfield.
Dancing to his left, and he'll just get rid of it.
Oh, I like that right there. Not only was it the right play, throwing it away like that, frankly, I think it was the only play.
Got outside of the pocket, realized he had nothing, just chucked it free.
Yeah, live to fight another down, right?
And he gets this one just shy of the 40, down at the 39. They get 14 on that one. That's good for Baltimore. First down. We knew he had the potential. potential to give this defense fits with his arm, but he's really giving them fits with his legs in this one.
Got tight knots, doesn't he? Because you can see the indecision all the way through. Because when you're defending an RPO and you have to have the proper assignments, that means you're thinking instead of reacting, and he's taking full advantage of that, having a big game.
2 yards on the carry there. It'll be second down. Another run here for Dobbins. Now third down is looming. A pickup of two on first down and just 1 yard there.
Typically, we think it's the strong safeties that are better tacklers, especially closer to the line of scrimmage that makes traffic. But in this case, how about the free safety coming up and making the big-time play?
A nickel set defensively for the Broncos here on third down. They're rolling out right. And Jackson going to have the first down as he will get to the ground to avoid the contact. It's a pickup of 11 and a Baltimore first down. This is something that we've seen from Lamar Jackson since back in his Louisville days. He can be so dangerous with the RPO.
Yeah, and whoever designed the RPOs, it's almost like they had a guy like Lamar Jackson in mind because of his ability to do everything. He can tuck it and throw it. He can tuck it and run it. He can hand it off inside when he gets the right read. The bottom line is most teams want him to hand it off because when he takes off and goes, he can break down a defense.
So a loss of five, and it'll be second down. And now Jackson will look to throw it. He'll check it down to Bell. Powers by at the 40. He's going to be out of bounds, but not before he takes it inside the 40. 17 yards is the pickup there for number 17. Discussions were at halftime to try to slow down this offense. It has not worked to this point.
Yeah, I have a vision right now of everything that was discussed at the half just being torn in shreds or being erased off of the Microsoft Surface tablets because none of it is working. They are really locked in on defense.
Officially, it's a 1 yard loss. That's going to bring up second and 11.
An interesting and intriguing decision there defensively because they kept extra DBs on the field despite seeing the multiple tight end look that came out for the offense.
I thought they were going to switch out of it. I didn't know if they felt they didn't have time or what the case was.
Well, in any event, the extra speed allowed for great penetration as they stuffed that one behind the line of scrimmage.
Nothing open downfield, so he'll throw it away. Not his best throw there, but where we sit right now in the third quarter, he's had a pretty good game throwing the football.
He certainly has, and it's not exactly at the point where we're doing four-minute offense yet, but they've got to think about, I'm not going to say milking the clock, but understanding clock management here on out.
An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. Off the play fake. Here's Jackson.
Receivers blanketed on both attempts, this time on third down.
Well, let's see how the offense still out there. They elect to go on fourth and 11. From the gun, Jackson. On the opening possession of this third quarter.
Obviously didn't want to surrender a touchdown and fall even farther behind, and we've gotten to know this team a little bit, haven't we? Couldn't you just see their defensive leaders telling the offensive guys, telling the quarterback, don't worry, we got you to start things off. You take it from there.
They'll start the drive with a run by Gordon. Able to plow forward up to about the 29, just shy of the 30. 5 yards on the carry. Good pickup on first down. After the pickup of five, here's second and five. From the gun, Bridgewater. He's got his 6'5 receiver. That's Tim Patrick. And he'll be out of bounds just shy of the 40. Getting it to him in space pays off big time. That winds up going for 31. So the big play gets him across midfield now for first and 10. From the shotgun, it's Bridgewater. Eluding the pressure right. And he's going to be out of bounds down around the 35-yard line. The improv on the scramble there gets him six, and that'll be second down.
They brought the blitz that time, and I thought they were going to get to him, but instead, he flipped it on its ear, and ended up picking up positive yardage.
I thought he was dead to rights, but you are exactly correct, sir. Able to turn that into a positive game. Second down. It's Gordon. Slipped one tackle, but no more as he's knocked to the deck behind the line of scrimmage. It'll be a loss of a full 3 yards there, and it also brings up third down. Bridgewater to throw it. And he's got it complete to Cortland Sutton. And he will have a Broncos first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. Bridgewater now looking to throw on first. Forced out to his left. And he's left with no option here but to throw it away.
They've given up a few first downs on this drive, but getting the incompletion there, that should give them something to build on and maybe turn the tide.
On second and 10, Bridgewater. This is Gordon on the ball. And he'll be a couple yards shy of the red zone here at the 22-yard line. Seven out of that, so they're left with a third and 3. Bridgewater now. Going to throw deep for the end zone. And this is intercepted, but they'll say it all bounds. Close to a turnover in the end zone. Turn it back. End zone, but he could not get the feet down. This will wind up incomplete. The kick by McManus is good. And this is back down to a 7-point game. Well, he was a spectator for much of this game. This is his first field goal opportunity of the entire contest, but he's able to connect.
Yeah, he had a pretty good seat to this one, didn't he? But let's face it, all kickers that you and I know, they want to contribute. They want their opportunity, and he seized his.
After splitting the uprights, McManus to kick it away. We'll see a return here from the end zone. The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive. Their lead back down to one score after the field goal a moment ago, so they'll be looking to string together a few first downs, likely on the ground as they begin first and 10. Now this is Le'Veon Bell with a reception. The completion, but they go in the wrong direction. A loss of yards, and now they're dealing with a second and long. They go play action with Jackson. He'll check this down to Dobbins out of the backfield. A gain of 4 on the play, and they're going to face a third down. They go play action now. Jackson. And down he goes, but he takes it up to the 40. Jackson on target to Brown for a Ravens first down. Now they'll run the option to the short side left. And they get to him after a gain of 6 to the 46. And in this situation with a lead fourth quarter, they're liking keeping the ball on the ground, I'm sure.
That's just smart football, but you know the defense has to know it as well. They've got to stop them here. So now we're going to see that loading the box in a big way. 6, 7, 8, 9, whatever's going to take. It's a little bit more pressure on your big offensive line.
Fourth quarter, down to the final 2 minutes. Now we've got a one-score game. So it's Raven football here as we welcome you back. They're facing facing a critical third down now as they try to hold on to this lead.
No.
Play action. It's Jackson. And look at this. They get the turnover they needed. It's intercepted. Picked out by Justin Simmons. And he's able to get it back here to the 43-yard line. A critical error there in a tight game in the fourth.
All you talk about is taking care of the football, and especially with a lead here in the fourth quarter. Turning it over, now the door is open for the opposition.
Just in general, when you're passing in the fourth quarter with a lead, no matter at what point, you gotta be super careful.
Gotta be careful, and sometimes you can be so careful that you end up running yourself into an error.
And he'll go out of bounds right around the 40. He'll get 3 yards on the scramble there at second down.
How about a tip of the cap to the defense? They're working against a very mobile quarterback, but all day long they've kept him under wraps. And on that play, they held him to a short gain.
Bridgewater. He'll go up top here for Hamler. And this is caught. KJ Hamler, 40 yards. And the Broncos are an extra point away from tying this game here in the final minutes. Don't forget the extra point. It's up and good. And partner, we've got a tie game here in the fourth. Nothing separating these two sides. 24 all our score as he sends this one away. This is going to be returned from the middle of the end zone. The Baltimore offense at the line, set to get going. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive? Or no, you just throw that out the window.
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, totally didn't affect me. Just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful. Not too cautious, because now you can't run any offense at all.
Yeah, on attack. We'll see how they attack him here. They have 3 yards on first down, just 1 yard there. Tie ball game in the fourth quarter.
And Brandon, when games are this close, it usually comes down to the team making the fewest mistakes. And that was one of our mantras back at Tennessee. Coach Major said all the time, the team making the fewest mistakes will win. You've got to cut those down to give yourself an opportunity.
That's out to the flat for Gordon. And down inside the 15. Now the Ravens going to use one of their timeouts, as they stop it here with just under 40 seconds to go in the game. Now Gordon on first down. And they get to him quickly here as he stops right around the 13. The Ravens going to use the second of their timeouts, as the clock will stop with 34 seconds to go in the game. Here's second and 9, just a yard on that last run. A little unconventional, but another kneel down here as they work towards a field goal try.
Team, but for their fans, as you mentioned, down going into the fourth quarter. How about about the rally? How about the comeback? Getting it done on both sides of the ball, holding them when they needed to, and finding ways to get points when they had the football.